with Gerald Diddick. And Pat DeFuso trying to get Kachuk to the bench. We even had a fan on the ice momentarily, and Troy Gamble helped him get back. Somebody threw Gamble's mask in the crowd. And now they've got it sorted out.
And now John Paddock is trying to get Don Kuharski. He wants some of the suspensions here that could be possible. And here's how it all starts.
Sandlot going after Elner.
And in comes Keith Kachuk. And in comes the rest of the Canucks. Robert Dirk. And look at John Paddock. He's on the Jets bench. He's saying, hey, I had all my guys standing right here. Now, how about the Canucks, who had all their guys on the ice? Now, Don Kuharski is...
Kuharski trying to get the Jets to their room. The Canucks now have pretty well all gone to their dressing room, but for three players, nobody's left the Jets bench.
A strong physical game by the Vancouver Canucks, and it's too bad that it ended this way. They played a good, strong physical game. They used their size. Trevor Linden had a great game. He bounced back. Played like the leader that he really is.
Sure sets the tone for game three, though. Look at the intensity on Randy Carlyle's face, and Don Kuharski and Pat DeFuso will try and sort this out.
They're still talking to Bob Hodges about it. Randy Carlyle, now Hodges goes over to help Kuharski and DeFuso. As you see, try and settle it out. Housley and Murray are the only two Jets on the ice.